Hi everybody, my name is Rita, aka Sunshine Echelon, and I'm here to tell you how this adventure for Echelon Conference started. So let's go back to August 2011. I saw a tweet by Alicia from NYC Echelon asking who wanted to have an Echelon convention in Europe, and I immediately said yes. And Kathy, which is my partner, she was the one wanting to have something here in Europe. So we started to talk and to, you know, put ideas together, little things we were remembering. We had a pool online for 12 European cities, and it started on August 23rd and went on to October 15. And then the five top cities went on to the second round. And that round ended at roughly in beginning of December. Such an attempt to have so many echelon together in one place for, you know, more than one day meeting. This actually had never been done in like 10 years that the band exists, and with so many echelon around the world and so many wonderful things that the echelon has made. So this to me was the big opportunity to give back not only to Mars but mostly to the echelon. So in December, when we decided that we were going to close the pools because Lisbon was so further up, and Lisbon was the spot, and I live in Lisbon, so yeah, that's a plus. I remember when I asked Tomo, well, is it something that you would like to see us do in the conference? Anybody that you think should speak? Because I want to make you proud. And Tomo looked at me and said, you want to make me proud? Take control. And so that's what me and Kathy did. We took control of on this conference. We discussed everything that was going to happen, what themes were we going to have at the conference. When we started the, you know, the registration forms, I was blown away. I thought at the most we would have like 50, 100 people, because you know it is so hard to get people together. I mean, when you have, everybody meets up online, but when you have like a physical meetup, when people have to be and go and do and, you know, get away from their lives and do something for free, for the echelon, for Mars, it is not easy. So I was blown away with all the registrations coming from, you know, countries like Spain, United States, Australia, France, Italy. I mean, it was insane. And so we had the registration, we had the agenda out, and we had all these people, you know, sending us the flight receipts, and we're like, oh my God, these people are really coming. This is going to happen. So at that point, Katie from This Is a Call to Arms, she offered to have the wristbands done, the Echelon Conference wristbands done. And so she did them and she brought them, and we had this goal to, you know, sell things at the conference and help that animal shelter that, you know, everybody knows now. They do a great job helping, you know, abandoned dogs, and I have the most respect for them because it's not easy. We had to have all the presentations, you know, secured. All of the people that I invited to speak at the conference really did go, and that was wonderful because I really wanted those specific people. Inida from the United States, I mean, a girl that I met in New York, she is, she's a firework. You know, she's my American version. I love her to death. I love you, Inada. And I wanted her to speak, and she did. She was the first one. Had no sleep whatsoever because she drove from Porto. And so that was really, really great effort, and I loved her speech.
The thing about Mars is that you have got to be on their trip, right? On their wavelength to get it. And you either get it or you don't. 30 seconds to Mars pushes the envelope. They spit in the face of convention and could care less what anyone thinks. They are unafraid to step outside of the box. In fact, hanging by the tips of their fingers on the ledge is what they do. This freedom allows them to create what they want, amazing kick-ass rock music, which is what they truly are. What makes 30 Seconds to Mars so special is the bond they share with their fans, serving as an inspiration for legions of fans to believe in your dreams, to stand up for what you believe in, is the message chanted by Jared Leto.
And then we had Lovisa. Oh my God, Lovisa. I cannot express how much I love and admire Lovisa. She's from Sweden, and I met her through Twitter, and we went to Vienna and Ohanem's gig together. And she has so much more strength than she thinks she does. And her speech was so emotional. So it was exactly, Jamie Lovisa, exactly what I wanted it to be. And it was. And of course, Tito and Rahul from Qatar and Katie gave a great presentation. We also had a person from Echelon House or Habitat for Humanity, which works with Echelon House.
It doesn't matter who you are, it doesn't matter where you come from, it matters how you are. This guy's crazy. I mean, this guy is crazy as F. And then he realized that this guy's crazy. So I guess that. Right.
Beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Oh, it's just
why did we have those things at the conference? Because, as I say like a thousand times, this is not only about music, and this is not only about how cool Tomo is, how great Shadimal is, how beautiful Jared is. This is not a fangirl, fanboy thing. This is a cult. And if you think what a cult is something that relies on the family, on the other cult members. And we need to give back. And that's what I think that a lot of people don't realize, that being an Echelon is not something that you just go to a gig and you are. No, it takes work, it takes more. And so that's why we wanted to have a call to arms and Echelon House, Habitat for Humanity, speaking at the conference. And that's why we had the sale to help the animals. I think that we really took a lot of things out of this conference. We took pride, we took joy, we took friendship, we took love. We'll be right back.
myself is better not said. Now I'm closer to the edge. It was 1,001 and 1,000,002 to go down flames and I'm taking you closer.
Very long process and very doubtful process, but it was not easy, definitely not easy, but at the end it was really worth it because everybody was so happy and both shows in Porto and Lisbon went so well. Great friend Elsa Cruz, she's the head of Echelon Portugal, and she was, I mean, I have no word to thank her because she was perfect. She was there for me and she calmed me down when I needed to, and you know, she gave opinions and she was wonderful. Not only her, I mean all the crew from Life on Mars Portugal were really, really helpful. Kathy, you did an amazing job. And all of the people that came from so many countries, I mean, I cannot tell how much I admire you and how much I love you and how much I thank you for coming and for making our dream come true.